some very lazy staff were there in the team. I still remember the project. Quickly, what happened at the end? All these people still survived in the office. The project manager stepped down. He was stepped down. He was forced to step down. And he couldn't take the embarrassment. He resigned in 2 weeks. But you know, shouldn't blame him. Shouldn't blame him. I know who worked. The people who actually caused the project to fail. All the developers, you know, all the technical people. But at the end, you know, blame goes to who? Project manager. Because it's project manager's responsibility to make the project work. Move according to the schedule. You have to force them to work. You have to make sure and show they work. So at the end, he stepped down. He was forced to step down. Like, kind of, you know, fired him from the project manager position. Then, after some time, he resigned. He couldn't take the, you know, the pressure. So he just resigned. So all this can happen, you know, not easy to be project manager, but the salary, I tell you, so nice. So interesting figure. A very interesting figure. Of course, you can reach 5 million in a very short period of time. If you make a lot of project success, you get a, promotion very easily. Very easy. I have one project manager at home. Okay? But the pressure is not easy. Like three, four years you lose your hair. You get older. You take picture before you become project manager and after you become project manager. You see big difference. That's the thing. Okay. So I think most of the project manager were gone through a lot of pressure. Okay? Especially when it comes to the projects, new release or whatever. Okay, to understand concept of inconsistency management, to explain the activity involved, differentiate qualitative and quantitative. For your information, right? Quantitative. For you. I just noticed there's a mistake. This is quantitative.
Okay, now
Okay? They always think intra means between different group. Inter means same group. It sounds like that. But no. Intra means within the same group. Intra means within the same group. Inter means within the different groups. Okay? Okay, interview points, each stakeholder has its own focus and concern. So meaning you know what? This stakeholder, let's say we have this two stakeholder. I have to collect requirement from both of them. Let's say library system. This stakeholder says, okay, the student can borrow and keep the book for 3 weeks. And this stakeholder says, the student can borrow and keep the book longer if they want. Clashing on. Yeah. previous university, I have online account. I just can click my menu button as many times as you want. Close to what? Expiry? View? I just click menu. I can renew as long as I want. So it's a different system. Here, I'm not sure because I've never been to the library. Very far. Very, very far. So I prefer online book rather than walking to the library. Okay? So I've never borrowed any book. Okay? So that's the example of destination plan. And the last one, structure plan. You know, structure is the way you put in information, the structure. So example, at one place you write Friday 5 p.m. Like now, assignment due. The system says assignment due. Okay? The lecturer says, okay, must submit the assignment by 5 p.m. today. But the system shows Friday only. So Friday means until 11:59. Now what is 11:59? The whole day until 24 hours over. So structure clash. So you mean only Friday 5 p.m.? Or when you say Friday, does it mean until 11:59? You understand the one? Is it 11:59 or is it 5? Clear? So that's the thing. Okay, next. Okay, now what two types of conflict? Very strong conflict, very weak conflict. Can you, anyone give me an example of strong conflict? Example of strong conflict? Okay, give you an example. If student attend the class, if student attend any class, tutorial, practical lecture, okay, 30 minutes later, okay, or 20 minutes after the class starts, no attendance given. No attendance given. One requirement says, if student attends 30 minutes after the class starts, no attendance given. Another one says, if student attend the class late, attendance still will be marked. One say no attendance, one say attendance marked. Clashing or not? You cannot come up with a requirement being satisfied both. Can or not? You say, one say this, one say this. Any overlapping? No overlapping, no overlapping. So do you think you can solve this? Very difficult to solve. I will teach you how to solve it. Strong conflict. So, strong conflict. You know, weak conflict means one say like this, the other one say maybe like this. So, still got some overlapping. So, either you can support either one. Whatever. So, not like, not very, not no very big difference. This one totally opposite. Totally opposite. Say yes, say no. So, this one strong conflict. Okay, if like this, weak conflict.
Patron shall return the borrowed copies within 10 weeks. Patron shall
Okay, these are the conflict. These are the two conflicting requirements of class. These are the two conflicting requirements. Okay, maybe I will take both of which. Okay, one stakeholder says patron shall keep. Okay, maybe. Okay, one stakeholder says a patron shall return the borrowed copies within next week. Then after next week, return. Okay, first one thing. Second one say, patron shall keep borrowed copies as long as they want. So, no need to return. Can keep as long as you want. Conflict on. Class conflicting? Yes. How to solve? Got five tactics. The first tactic. Avoid boundary condition. Keep copies of highly needed books and go over. You don't support the first one. You don't want to support the second one. Avoid the boundary totally. Avoid the conflict totally. How to avoid the conflict totally? Second book, don't allow anyone to borrow. If you let them borrow, they keep. Whether they want to keep long or they want to keep short, we don't bother. Some books, highly borrowable. People really want. Everyone now want to borrow because very useful books. So don't allow anyone to borrow.
Dropping one of the requirements, so no clash.
So we withdraw. It's no, like, you know, 3 weeks only, that's the meaning. So it didn't explain whether we can borrow again or, you know, we borrow continuously again. No explanation given. So when you say you want to draw, what you have to do, you know, you have to find out which one is lower priority. So which one is lower priority, who can help me? Which one? Hey, okay, come to staff and patron. Which one is lower priority? Patron is borrower. Who knows better about library? Staff. So staff is always higher priority because this is something to do with the rules, right? Rules, who know better? Staff know better. You cannot ask the student. Student always tell, I want to keep for so many days. Correct. So you have to go for higher priority. I will go for this is higher priority because position is staff. Okay, student is considered low position when it comes to hierarchy of library. So higher priority because higher position. Can you understand? So which one you draw? The second one. Yes. Okay, next. Specialize the conflict source or target. Okay, which one is source, which one is target? Requirement comes from who? Class? Class. Requirement comes from who? Source is comes from who? This one comes from who? Staff. This one comes from who? Borrower. Okay? This is source. This is source. This is source. Okay, what about target? Target is? Both also talk about who? Patron. Both also talk about patron. Patron. Okay, now tell me. Can I specialize the target? Can I specialize the target? No way. Because both also the target is the same. So, the clashing is not the target. You understand or not? The clashing is not the target. So, I cannot do anything with the target. But can I do something with the source? What can I say? What do I say? I can say this requirement only we take from the librarians. We don't allow students to give like what is this requirement. So, we specialize the source. So, we say this requirement only comes from librarians. So which requirement is selected? Again, staff. This one, straight away, no more. Understand? So specialize the source or target means you identify who can be the target or who can be the source. So the other one can be ignored. Ignored. Okay, when you specialize the source, you say this requirement must come from librarian only. If you specialize the target, for example, you can say, okay, that's the answer for source. If you want to target, specialize the target also can. How? Who can tell me? How to specialize the target? Who can tell me? Okay, I can say students shall return the book within X3. Staff shall keep borrowed book copies as long as they want. I specialize the target. Also can. I can get two different solutions. Solve the problem. You understand or not? So when you specialize, the requirements are not clashing. You are using patron, patron, no problem. When you use different terms, make it clear, no clash. Understand? Okay, class, now listen. Assignment, assignment. You have to, every student, you have your own module, right? Of course, I'm not asking you to do now. I'm just explaining, relating with what I teach today. So you can try to think first when you have time. You have your own module, right? In your own module, can you identify one set of requirement? One set means two requirements clashing each other. Of course, you create yourself. Okay? You try to come up with some requirement example which clash each other. Your own module. Every student, you have your own module, right? So you have to identify two requirements, one set of requirement which clash each other. After you get the two requirements which clash each other, you have to perform all the five tactics to solve it. I want to see all the five example of solution. Then what you have to do? Of course I want try your best to come up with five. Some student told me, Miss, mine is very strong clashing conflict. I cannot do restore or return, cannot. resolution. Okay? After giving me the 5 resolutions, last one, I want you to evaluate all the 5 resolutions and choose one. Of course, you cannot do all 5. You only implement one. So you tell me which one is going to be your solution. You resolve using one technique, only one. So you can justify. You know what is justify? Give reason for each resolution. Which one is good, which one is not really good for your project. Then finally you choose one. Finally choose one. First come up with 5 resolution order. Okay, then choose one. If really very strong conflict, cannot give me 5 resolutions, maybe 3. Okay. Okay, but if I can find out the 5 resolution, then I minus your marks. So you have to really check. If you cannot, give me all the 5 resolution order. If possible, then better do. Okay? Then choose one. Evaluate and choose one. Discuss and justify why. I want the justification, no marks. Okay? So every module, one conflict. Every module, find 2 requirements which are conflicting with each other. Clear? You understand what I mean, right? Okay.
So that's the work given. Okay. I covered my syllabus for today, I think. Any questions?
Thank you.